And we have got an awesome concert lined up for you this afternoon. And yes, it is kind of a pity that we're not outside, but it's a lot of fun performing in here. It's an intimate situation. And I can tell you from personal experience, it's a lot of fun to play inside here. You're in for a special treat. Just have a couple of announcements to make here. This concert is part of the summer entertainment series. It's made possible through our title sponsor, the Red River Co-op, and also the Johnston Group and the Scotiabank. And the Leo Mall series specifically is brought to you by the Richardson Foundation. There's been a lot of new updates around the park. I'm sure you can see what they've been doing around here. You can check out assiniboinepark.ca to find out all the details of what's happening in the park. And also, if you'd like to make a donation to the park, there will also be some park staff coming around with butterfly nets. If you want to make a cash donation for what's going on in the park, they certainly gratefully acknowledge your donation. I'd like to tell you a little bit about our title artist this afternoon. I'm going to give him the chance to introduce the band, but I'd like to just tell you a little bit about Mr. Connor Derraugh, a little bit about my history with Connor, and I'll let him take care of the musical introductions and so on. But I met Connor a number of years ago, actually the backstage of the Lyric Theater. I was performing there, and Connor was a young lad at the time and very enthused about music, and I had a chance to have a brief discussion and get to know him. And not too long afterwards, I'm not sure exactly of the dates or how many years went by or whatever, but not too long afterwards, I became aware that Connor had had a serious medical condition that compromised the right side of his body in a very serious way. And this, being a musician and a saxophone player myself, I was quite alarmed to hear this. So I contacted the family. I wanted to get in touch with Connor. I wanted to go and see him, perhaps in the hospital, but that didn't work out. But I did get a chance to visit him at home shortly after he returned home. And, you know, when I heard that this had happened to him, that he'd had something serious happen to him, I was immediately concerned, first of all, that he would have a problem with playing, have a problem with his love of music and being able to express his music. But when I got over to Connor's house, I could see instantly that his musicality and the way he could express himself was all fully there. Yeah, he had some issues with his right hand and some various things, but we joyously had a jam session and connected as friends right there, right immediately, a few weeks after he'd had his incident. And so we became friends, and Connor was, I think, predominantly playing keyboards at the time. But being a sax player, I thought, you know, Connor, you should maybe get into playing some saxophone, because it might be a little better with your right hand the way it is and as you're recovering. And so he was gung-ho. So we used to get together all the time, and we didn't really have lessons. We used to just kind of hang out and play saxophone. And we had a chance to discuss a lot of cool things about playing the saxophone. And we mainly just kind of played and became friends. And so over the years, I had a chance to witness Connor's his healing, you know, both you know, physically and his maturity level as a musician. And he's kind of a similar guy to myself in that, you know, when I grew up, my focus wasn't so much to the academia of school and that sort of thing. It was more or less learn to play, get out there, learn to entertain people and be a musician, make some money, buy a car, rent an apartment, and just play music. So Connor's kind of got that vibe going on. I can tell you that because many of my gigs he'll come and sit in. He's not only a musician, he's an entertainer. And he's concerned about getting the emotion and the whole aspect of music across to the audience. So I've had a chance to be on a tour with him and be on several gigs. And so I feel close to Connor in that way, and that a lot of musicians take it so seriously that they put the entertainment side of it aside, and they're, you know, they just don't put the emphasis on the audience as much. And I think Connor's got a bright future, not only as a saxophone player, but as an entertainer, and just bringing the joy of music to those that are fortunate enough to be in his presence. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please put your hands together and welcome Connor Derraugh.
Can you? this is really cheesy to say, but we couldn't have done this without you. So thank you very much. So that first song was obviously a Stevie Wonder classic, Sir Duke. And that's the theme of the show. We're going to be doing music from Stevie Wonder and Ray Charles. So, you know, two awesome musicians that I can't say enough about, that love their music. But one of the big reasons why I chose to do this concert was not only do I love their music, but they really inspire me because they both had to overcome like big adversity to make it in the music world. And that's kind of something that I'm having to go through too. And so, you know, so they really inspire me to work hard, and, you know, they went through something, I'm going through something. So, you know, so that's a big reason why I chose to do their music today. So now we're gonna, obviously you can see we flip-flop singers. So that was Micaylee and Rodyniuk on the first tune, Sir Duke. And now we're gonna welcome up Kelsey Rosencheddar on the next tune, Let the Good Times Roll. Yeah, so my dad made a Microsoft Word document of stuff for me to say after every song so I don't forget, because I definitely will. Anyways, so first of all, so Walle, who introduced me, so he did give me sax lessons. He just calls it hanging out, but it really was, you know, it really was lessons. But he gave, he actually gave 2 full years of free sax lessons. Wouldn't take anything. But my dad felt bad, so he brought his first cookbook, the first lesson, second cookbook, the second lesson, then homemade super bread just because he felt bad. But after 2 years with Walle in grade 10 and grade 11, he was going to be in LA for most of my grade 12 years, so he said, like, you're going to need to find a new sax teacher. So basically right when Walle left, Craig Bailey came for the year for the sax, U of M sax prof job. And turns out Craig played in Ray Charles' band for 17 years. So that was a cool connection. But first time I went to the hang, I played, and he came up to me, I really want to teach you sax lessons, blah, blah, blah. So we just hung out all the time. It was super cool. He was just a great mentor to me. But the one thing I'll never forget him telling me was that Ray Charles once said, after about a year or so in Ray's band, he pulls Craig into his office and says, "Hey Ray, when are you gonna stop playing notes and start making music?" And that was incredibly deep and obviously made, you know, Craig feel bad. But, you know, he definitely has worked on it since then. So anyways, so now we're gonna do a Ray Charles ballad called "I'll Drown in My Own Tears."
Just come on home. Is it she wonder? Oh, is it?
I never know how, when that, after you finish a song, I don't know what the right first thing to say is. You know? From a true professional. So I guess it was 2 years, or last year, my sax prof, John Gordon at school, well, everyone knows how big of a David Sanborn fan I am. That's just, you know, basically common knowledge at this point. But I told John, my teacher, that my parents surprised me and were taking me down to Omaha, Nebraska, I think, to see him. And so John says, oh my God, that's great. He says, you know what, just hold on one second. And he dials a phone on, he's dialing a number on the phone, and then he says, hey Phil, how's it going? I'm like, oh my God, he's talking to Phil Woods right now. He was pulling Phil Woods in the middle of my lesson. I'm like, how is that even possible? So anyways, so he phones him up, and they connected me to meet Dave when I was down there. So I ended up going to sound check, meeting with him briefly, and then he says, I want to talk to you more after the show. And it was just me, my parents, and him in the dressing room for an hour just talking. And it was obviously one of the most incredible experiences of my life. But Dave told me a couple of things. He says, first of all, whenever I play, there's three things I'll never forget. Gratitude, humility, and patience. And he said when he plays, you know, he doesn't think about what happened yesterday or what's going to happen or the girl in the third row that's kind of cute or, you know, he only just thinks about one thing, and it's just being grateful to be alive and share his music with others. And so that, you know, obviously relates to me really well. But so now we're going to play a song that actually Sanborn played in his set when I recently saw him a couple months ago. And so here's Stevie Wonder's Another Star. One, two, three. just want to say before we go on. Oh man, it's a bother. Before, yeah, sure. My throat also just started drying up like crazy. But yeah, so before we go on, I just want to say like how I met everyone in the band. Hold on.
It's so emotional.
This is really hard. no, but so Micaylee and Kelsey, the vocalists of today, I go to U of M with them. Micaylee's in my ear, Kelsey's the ear behind, but Kelsey gave me rides to school like constantly, and so and Micaylee also helped out with rides too, so because they live right by me, which is very nice. So then the drummer Ben Kidd, give me a hand. So I want to say that I met you maybe at IMC.
Yeah,
IMC, International Music Camp. And so the group was like Lauren, Emily, you, me, and others.
Yeah,
and then you ended up getting married to one of them, which is kind of cool.
Not you.
No, not me. Luke, I met at U of M Jazz Camp. We were in the same group probably 6 years ago or something like that. Crazy. And he just graduated from U of M this year.
Yeah,
yeah, cool. So big hands for him. Carter, I believe we met somehow at U of M. Maybe at the jazz camp or.
I think I probably saw you in camp.
Probably at the hang too. Yeah, cool. Well, give a big hand to Carter. Is a U of M graduate here except for the trumpet player.
Ooh.
You went to U, Brandon. But I'm trying to remember how we met now.
It was a long time ago.
It was very long ago.
Actually, I know exactly when it was. We played.
I used to teach, I don't know if any of you know Mark Tugby, the bass player.
Yep.
I used to teach Mark trumpet, and we had a jam session. And Mark asked me to come and play, and I said yes, and it would be fun. So we went over to his house and we played, and Connor was playing piano. I don't know how long ago that was, but...
It was long.
That's the first time.
Yeah, cool.
What's his name?
His name is Andrew Littleford.
Oh,
okay, so now that all the introductions are out of the way, now we will bring up Micaylee to sing Ray Charles' classic, Georgia on My Mind.
On my mind.
So, we've reached that time. Yes, last song. I just want to say thank you to everybody who came out this afternoon. I know the weather's pretty crummy, but you know, the show still has to go on, and it did go on because you guys came here. If we were playing to an empty room, we'd still get paid, but be a real bummer, you know. So I'm really happy you guys could all come out. So close to that. Yeah, thank you again to these amazing musicians for agreeing to do this gig with me. And next week, make sure to come back. Helen White is playing here for week two in the Jazz Garden, so that should be pretty cool. And big thanks to Assiniboine Park for putting on these free shows. It's, you know, we get the Leo Mall shows during the afternoon on Sundays, then we get the Lyric Theater shows at night, and they're all for free. So just big thanks to Assiniboine Park. This last song, we're actually going to bring up both singers for a duet. So Ray Charles did this song called Heaven Help Us All off his CD Genius Loves Company. And so he brought in a different artist for every song and he did live duets. So this song is with Gladys Knight. But this song is also recorded, I think, in the 70s or 80s by Stevie Wonder. But it's actually a Ron Miller song, but both Stevie and Ray did it, so, and I love this song, so I thought it'd be, you know, really appropriate for what I'm doing. So here's Heaven Help Us All. last year when I played this for the first time, I came a couple weeks beforehand and watched an act, and afterwards people just got up and left, and so I said, okay, I'm just going to get my set, that's it, that's all I'm going to worry about. And we finished the set, and then people stood up and won an encore. I was like, I didn't rehearse anything else with the band. So I turned around and I was like, hey guys, do you want an encore? And they're like, what do we play? I was like, I don't know. And so it was like this like panic, but it worked out. But
that was the first thing you planned for this year.
So this year I was like, okay, I got it worked out, you know. So we're going to actually play one of Andrew Littleford's arrangements of, and it needs no introduction. You'll know it right away.
Yeah.
Rodyniuk on vocals. And again, Rodyniuk on vocals.